Too late, fellas! No!
No!
Alex, you are in a serious lot of trouble.
Hang on, where's Dylan?
Dylan? Damn it, Dylan! Isabella! Doctor! Where have they gone now?
Dylan!
Ah, who cares? I'm sure it's...
Alex!
Isabella, no, it's too late. There's nothing we can do. Sorry, Doctor. Damn it, Dylan! You had one job! So what's going to happen now? I guess this is game over.
You're giving up? Doctor, you can't give up!
Isabella, we're surrounded by sidemen. Look around. What else can we do?
The Doctor must be destroyed.
Oh, end transmission! Right, glasses off, everybody. Dylan, you had one job!
I'm sorry.
Oh, we were so close to beating my high score. Well, that's enough fun and games for tonight. You have homework to do and you've got work early tomorrow, Dylan, so I'm taking you both home.
What's the point of having a time machine if we're gonna have to go to school anyway?
And work. Well, I went to school just like you did.
Really?
I went to work, I went to school, I studied just like you. I wasn't born in the TARDIS, you know?
What school did you go to then? Some posh one in London?
No, I studied at the Academy of Time at the foot of Mount Caden.
You know, half the time I don't even know what he's talking about.
Tell me about it.
Right, you two, off you go. Go have fun.
Right.
See you later.
Having this nightmare every time, every night. It varies, but it always consists of the same thing. A clown. Always a clown. I've been having these nightmares for years, ever since I was little. I don't know what causes it. I don't know why I get them. What do you think causes it? Can you help me?
Well, you've definitely come to the right place. See, people think that dreams and nightmares are just random, but it's so much more complex than that. There are certain triggers, words and memories that cause us to dream. And even crazier than that, I can use the TARDIS to find out what's causing your dream.
Really? How?
Because, Isabella, the TARDIS can do anything, or just about, but specifically, telepathy, my dear. If you link your mind into the TARDIS and think really, really hard about the monsters, about that nightmare, then we should be able to pinpoint the exact memory that triggers those nightmares and go there.
Are you sure that's gonna help? It might make things worse.
Sometimes things aren't as bad as we remember them when we were younger. And even though at the time it may have been scary, going back there as an adult, you might realise that it's not actually as bad as it seemed. There might be nothing to fear.
I have a really bad feeling about this. But it's worth a shot.
Isabella, can you just pop your hand on here, please? Thank you very much. I need you to concentrate now.
On what?
On your nightmare. On your worst nightmare, your biggest fear. The thing that keeps you awake at night.
I'll try.
Right. Vamos! Let's do this! Oh, come on, old girl! Can do this!
Wait, who are you calling old girl?
I was talking to the TARDIS! Right, out, now! It's gonna be quite a while before the TARDIS can take off again.
Oh my god! Where is this? Doctor, where are we?
I'm not sure. I just need to run into the TARDIS to check quickly. One second. What? What? No. No, we can't. Isabella, what are you doing?
What am I doing? What are you doing slamming the door?
No, it wasn't me. I didn't touch anything.
What are you doing?
Isabella, back away from the door immediately. Isabella, stay there. Do not move. I promise you I will find you.
Doctor!
True. How?
Why? Why would you do this? It's your fault. I can't get the TARDIS out of here.
Only you would have done something like this.
But I said not to leave the TARDIS.
And what do you do?
How? How did you? You got us stuck here, and now we can't get out.
Only someone like you would have done this.
Forever. We're just forever now. We're here stuck because of you.
Alex sounded like such a cool guy to hang out with.
He did a bit. He just didn't have any stupid clown issues.
Yeah. Having nightmares? How old are you? Are you some sort of kid?
You know, we should have bought Alex instead, you know? I get what he meant now.
He would have been so much cooler to hang out with, better than you.
He probably wouldn't have got us stuck on Clown World.
Yeah, what is this with you and clowns?
I mean, you really think that we care about your dreams?
We don't care, we don't know you.
Oh, this is absolutely useless, the fact that we're stuck here now.
It's not real.
Typical. With this guy here, you know, we may as well stay with him instead of you.
It's not real. Go away! What the?
Go towards the gate.
Hello? Who are you? What do you want with me?
Gate.
No, I won't. It's bound to be a trap.
Go towards the gate.
I said no, and there's nothing you can do to make me go there.
We'll see.
Ah! No!
Isabella, can you hear me?
Doctor? Oh my god, Doctor, can you hear me?
Isabella, can you hear me? Isabella? Don't go in there! Isabella!
I'm Buddy the Clown, and I've got a special present for you. It's that thing you've always wanted. All you gotta do is come over here.
Do not go near it. You can't.
What thing?
You know, that thing you've always wanted. Now come a little closer and you'll get to see it.
Don't go near it, Isabella. You can't. Isabella, you mustn't.
Oh dear.
What's wrong with you?
Oh, it must have been something I ate. Oh, I was worried this would happen.
I'm coming.
Doctor!
Isabella! Finally! Brilliant! I knew I'd eventually manage to get that to work. Just had to keep trying, is all.
Doctor, what's going on? Are you coming back for me?
Isabella, I'm trying to. I really am. But the TARDIS says that you're trapped on a planet outside of the universe. It isn't letting me get back to you.
Well, you're gonna have to think of something. I can't stay here the rest of my life.
Isabella? Isabella, hello. Are you still there?
Doctor! Can you hear me? Did you hear what I said?
Ah! Oh, Isabella, come on. Please pick up.
There's no way you can save her. It's too late. She's beyond your reach, even for you, Doctor.
It knows you.
I know you. I know both of you. I can read your thoughts, your mind. Oh, you've lived a dangerous life, Doctor. Full of death and destruction. You've had so many names over the years. The oncoming storm. The shadow of the Valiard. The timeless child. The destroyer of the Cluster 14. The legend of the Devastator.
Doctor, what's it talking about?
And you, Isabella. The girl hiding from Mummy and Daddy. You do realize they never truly did love you.
Doctor, I...
Isabella, don't listen to it.
The clock is ticking, Doctor. You're running out.
out of time.
So, let's get this straight. You're on a planet, you're trapped on a planet, outside of the universe, and you're trying to use the nightmares of a frightened young girl to get back here. Come on, you can talk to me. You've read my mind. You know what I'm capable of. You know who I am. Tell me.
I was sent here as a punishment for a crime I didn't commit.
Yeah, yeah, that's what they all say. I've heard it before. So that's it, isn't it? You're trying to return to this reality through Isabella's nightmares. Well, no more. It stops here. You hear me, Isabella?
Yes, Doctor.
Right, here's what I need you to do. I need you to just clear these things from your head. Clear the nightmares, clear the images of your head. Meditate, go to your happy place. They only exist whilst you're thinking about them. Right, Isabella, I need you to listen to me. So, the only way I can get you back is if we do what we did before. We need to re-establish a link between you and the TARDIS. Now, we can do this over the phone. But this is where things get really difficult. I'm gonna need you to think about your nightmare again.
But Doctor, you said...
I know I told you not to think about them before, but it's the only way I can get the TARDIS to lock onto you. You need to think about them.
Doctor, if I think about that nightmare, it's gonna come to life, isn't it? Well?
Yes. So we have to act fast. The moment the TARDIS lands there, you need to run. You need to get the hell out of there.
I'm scared.
Isabel.
You can do this.
No, I can't.
Yes, yes you can, Isabella.
I know you can. I believe in you. You've just got to believe in yourself. Because I know you're capable of doing amazing things.
Okay. I'm ready.
Isabella?
Doctor?
Good luck. Now! Isabella! Concentrate! Isabella, come on.
Doctor!
I'm sorry, it's my fault. It's all my fault.
Now, Doctor, the nightmare.
Oh.
What do I do? What if I remember them again? Doctor!
I'm sorry, Isabella. I don't know. I really don't know.
When we first met, I told you that I thought I was no one. I was so depressed and I thought there was no point in anything. But there was one thing I forgot to tell you. The day we first met, the day I appeared in the TARDIS, I tried to kill myself. I was on the edge of the car park rooftop. Closed my eyes and jumped, and then I appeared here.
I never knew.
I thought it was better that way, but I made my decision that day. I wanted to die, but then everything changed. Can you help me, Doctor? Can you cure my depression?
No.
But you said...
I never said. Isabella, we all have to face our demons. But you don't have to face them alone. You've got me, you've got Dylan, you've got the TARDIS. But what I can do is show you.
Show me?
Look. When we met, I showed you the stars from Earth. But see, these are different stars.
What do you mean?
These stars, these are the stars from my bedroom window. From my home, back on my planet. When I was young, I used to look up at these stars, and I used to dream of flying between them, of weaving between the stars like a kite in the night sky. And it's just amazing how we're made of elements which are composed within the hearts of collapsing stars. So, when you think about it, we're all made of stardust, even you. You know, Isabella, I don't think it was coincidence that we met. The universe, it acts in strange, mysterious ways. And there are sometimes opportunities. This is yours. This is your opportunity. You see, we all need time to heal. In my previous life, my previous incarnation, I spent a long time thinking about what I had done. But then I realized I knew it was time to change. And the same's got to happen to you. And no matter what you choose, Isabella, just know that we'll always be here for you, all of us. Every time. Isabella! Isabella! Isabella!
Sorry.
I never got to say. But I'm sorry for everything I put you through. Just remember, just that nobody's really gone. They're always with you in heaven.